someone every day.
I would love to. It feels really homely here, actually.
Yeah.
Chilling out back, having bacon sandwiches.
Yeah, we'll have the house doctor in, sorting out everything.
Yeah. Nice.
Whatever. Life hasn't been too bad for you after the Spice Girls, really, when you think of the transition. It's been hard work for you, but this is now your what single?
Fifth single. Yeah.
Right. So you've put a lot of work into it, you've appeared a lot of TV programmes and whatever it is. Would you deem it so far to be a success?
Yeah, I think because, you know, I've had singles that people really remember, and I think that's the main thing for me. I want people to remember my songs and me, and, you know, just that's what I'm here for, to make good pop songs, really.
It took you so long.
And free.
And that was number one, wasn't it?
That was. Because my daughter will be at school now and she won't be embarrassed then to face anybody.
I'm afraid of too many things.
Do you
remember that one?
Yeah. But say for instance, and we've had lots and lots of people. Remember, we had the Appletons on here a few weeks ago, and then they had.
But
they had their record contract taken away from them, so they did.
They didn't get in with that.
Say this didn't get anywhere. Would this be really depressful? Would it?
I think so.
Yeah.
You know, I enjoy it so much, and that's the main thing for me, to get up and perform. So yeah, if that was taken away, I'd be very upset. You know, it's something I love doing. But then again, you know, I'm looking forward to so many other things as well. I'm still very young, so I would hopefully never, you know, get depressed. But I enjoy it so much, I'd hate that to be taken away from me.
It's a hard business, though, but it is a job and it is your profession, which a lot of people forget. And you've grown in that job and that profession. You've gained experience like anyone does when they've been around for a long time.
Absolutely.
So do you feel more confident with all that?
So much more confident. I've been in the studio now for about 9 months doing the album, which is going to be out at the end of the year. And I've been so much confident. I've been kind of in the studio on, you know, turning up the bass and making sure the music's right, and then writing the lyrics and doing melodies. And, you know, with Free Me, it's just, I've had so much input. It was amazing, you know, just felt great. I went to all the string sessions. It was beautiful.
And so what sort of sound would you describe this as?
I would definitely describe it as classic, timeless, but contemporary.
Very summery, we've heard you.
Very summery. And also I'm hopefully bringing back a bit of that 60s. Where's that liveness gone? That's what I wanted. And I think you can really
just
tell that
pure
in my
pop
album.
Sort of stuff.
Yeah, and all live instruments.
Would
and
you ever enter Eurovision talking about live?
Oh.
Did you watch it?
I did, and do you know what? I'm sorry, I feel so sorry for the guys, and I think, you know, we need to be a bit more supportive. Bless them, they've come home, they must be devastated.
But they haven't looked devastated or said they were devastated.
They're very
happy. Oh,
they?
Oh,
they're very, oh, they're very, good. I think, is that good?
They're in on Tuesday.
You know, I think they need to, you know, they worked so hard, obviously, and they went out there, and you could tell that they were so nervous.
Well,
it's so nerve-wracking when you're up there.
They've trained like you did. I mean, you went to Sylvia Young stage school, didn't you?
Yes.
And so and they've trained in the same way at the so-called Fame Academy in Liverpool, because that's not its actual name, is it? But they call it the Fame Academy in Liverpool anyway. So do you think that training stands you in good stead? Because Denise Van Outen's been through that.
Absolutely, but I think I still get so nervous when I go on stage. So for them to, you know, and they're still very new at it, so nerve-wracking.
I sit and shake here every single morning.
Not knowing what's coming next.
Here. What about Justin? What happened there?
Do you know what? I was quite upset on Sunday because I was totally misquoted. All I said was, he's got a nice bottom, and I think all us girls think that.
Well, he gropes everyone else, so why shouldn't someone say about
him? Exactly, so I was very misquoted on Sunday, but you know, that's what happened.
Yeah. He's a very nice lad. I've met him in here. But Brittany, on the other hand, she's a...
I thought she was a sweetheart.
Well, she's gorgeous and everything, but she can be a right wee bit of a madam.
Can she?
Oh.
Come on, tell us the story. What happened?
He met her, I forgot about him.
What happened?
She's not as nice as you, let's put it that way.
Oh, well, you see. Yeah. And that's why you'll do well, because people will want you to do well, and the record companies will, we can't get.
But she probably won't talk to you now, of course, because you fancy Justin's bottom. That's the whole thing. That'll be a whole new rival.
Hey, what about the acting side? Haven't you just got an acting part as well?
That's true. I'm going to be doing a little kind of cameo on Absolutely Fabulous.
No.
I'm really excited about
it
because, you know, I've known Jennifer for a while, and I'm just really looking forward to it. It'll be a fun piece to do.
I do a bit of acting myself, you know. I was on the Basil Brush show this week. What is all laughing about?
Were you playing the late Mr. Derek or something?
I was just trying to share my experience with Emma there. It was action, there were clapperboards and everything, and I was acting with television. Yes, the way she's going into now.
We love you for that. Yeah. I love Basil Brush as an institution,
yes,
actually.
Yes, Miss Fiona.
Yeah. Do you remember Basil Brush from his
first?
Boom, boom.
Mr. Derrick.
Boom,
boom. Yeah. Boom. Yes, of course yeah. I do.
Which you said to Justin, boom, boom.
Awful. Where did Basil Brush start out? Because he didn't originally have the Basil Brush show. He was on someone else's show. Whose show was it? It was David Nixon. Exactly. I said David Nixon to you.
That's right. But you are much older than me, so that's why you would remember that. That's excellent. Emma, we look forward to...
I don't even notice it anymore, Emma. The insults go over my head.
Emma, there's a score to equal here. Thank you. Emma, we'll see you later on.
Yes.
Because you're going to be singing for us.
I am, and it's out now as well.
Don't be out of tune or anything else. This is not Eurovision. Okay?
We're going to
see you.
Have you bought it yet?
No, but I will.
Good.
Listen, if you could see my CD rack in my car, you are there.
Thank you.
No, the album, you see, I'd wait for the album, which is out at the end of the year.
I'm a singles man myself.
But we would urge everyone else to go out and buy a single.
Well, I like singles, because you know when you put them on your car and things, then you don't want...
I cannot imagine you knowing what singles are.
Because when you get an album, they come to tracks you don't like. And if you have, and then you want to flick over them, see, so the singles are better.
I can't imagine you gyrating around in your car.
I wouldn't give you credit for that. See, thank you, Emma. Well, there we go. Thank you very much. Miss Emma Bunton, live in the flesh. She's singing for us right after this.
To sing a new single, Free Me. Here she
is. It's lovely.
Emma Bunton. Hey.
Brilliant.
Emma, very, very James Bondy, I thought,
actually,
isn't it?
Actually, yeah, you're right.
Very James, like that. Very, very good. Very some. It's funny how she was looking at that camp, looking at me when she was saying, "Seduce me."
Let me lose. Love you. That's what you.
What? I got the message. I tell you.
Lovely song, very summery. Do you see what we mean now by saying it was summery?
Very good, very good. Thank you,
lovely.
Boys. Thank you all. Your strings were perfect. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Sashaying into summer with Emma Bunn.